So let's first try and understand the math behind producing more ethanol. So typically, it takes 60% more cane to produce a liter of ethanol as compared to 1 kilogram of sugar. Let's just get the table up. If you take this number, you arrive at a conversion rate of 1.6. Now, if you divide this 1.6 by the revised ethanol prices, you arrive at the realization in sugar terms per kilogram. So if you take the number 1.6 and divide it with the 43.6, which is the price for per liter of C-heavy ethanol produced from C-heavy molasses, you arrive at a realization of 27.16. Now, given that the All India average sugar realization stands at the band of 30 to 31 rupees per kilogram, producing more ethanol from B-heavy molasses and cane juice is far more remunerative, as that could give you a realization of about 33 rupees and 37 rupees respectively. So now that we know producing ethanol is more lucrative than it has been in the past, what would it mean if a sugar company were to produce more of it and less of sugar that it has been doing in the past? We try and explain this with the help of an illustrative example based on our interactions with several sugar companies, industry experts and analysts. So as we could see in the past, sugar accounted for a majority of the company's top line. Almost 90% of revenues came from sugar, whereas ethanol accounted for less than 5%. Now, going forward, if the sugar company were to produce more ethanol, how would the dynamics change? Typically, let's first try and understand how the sugar business works. Since sugar prices are determined by the production, in years such as FY16 and FY18, due to surplus sugar production, the margins went as low as negative, in the negative territory, and that had a significant impact on the bottom line as well. Now, going forward, since ethanol prices are fixed by the government, margins there are relatively stable, and that reduces the cyclicality of earnings for sugar mills and boosts the profitability. So going forward, from an FY18 base of about 1,000 crores and a net profit of about 50 crores, that number could jump up to as much as 105 crores in FY19 and to 165 crores in FY20, according to our interactions with these people. What it also does is that it helps address one of the most teething problems for the industry, and that is of the high cane arrears. However, all of these benefits, they may take a year or two to settle in, as most of the sugar companies are expanding their distillery capacities. So all of the big names like Dhampur Sugar, DCM Shriram, Triveni Engineering, Sri Renuka, all of these are expanding their capacities, which would be coming on stream over the next 12 to 18 months. However, these are not the only positives. There are multiple tailwinds that the industry is going through right now. One of which is the reduced production from producing ethanol. So ethanol serves two purposes. Not just it helps in the financial health of the company, but it also reduces the sugar output in the ongoing season. For the current season alone, the OMCs have placed tenders for about 50 crore liter of ethanol, of which about 48 crores is expected from the B-heavy molasses and about 2 crore liters from cane juice. Now, factoring in that, ISMA, which is the industry body, says that if the companies were to produce that much ethanol, it would reduce the sugar output for the current season by about 500,000 tons, which stands at about 32 million tons. So that is a big positive. And sugar companies that we speak to, they expect that the crop next year too could be lower than the one that has been seen this year. So that is a key positive. Secondly, international prices of sugar, they have run up by more than 25% in the last 1 month on the back of lower output in Brazil. They are expected to produce 9 million tons less of sugar due to heavy rainfall in key cane growing regions, as well as robust ethanol demand. So there they are diverting most of the cane and producing less sugar. And with the government incentivizing exports through transport subsidy and direct cane payments to the farmers, that is an added positive for the industry. And with the rupee depreciating as well, that would be something that would be a key positive going forward when it comes to the sugar industry.